Hi, I'm Johannes Kirschner. In this video, I'm going to present joint work with Tor Lattimore and Andreas Krause on information-directed sampling for linear partial monitoring. Linear bandits are a model I think many of you will be familiar with. In this setting, there's an unknown and fixed parameter theta in RD that defines the rewards. The learner has access to a set of actions with associated d-dimensional features. The set of actions is denoted by script X and for now can be either finite or continuous. The learner interacts with the environment on n rounds. In each round, the learner picks one of the actions and then observes a noisy reward. The reward is the inner product between x, t, and theta. The learner's goal is to maximize the total reward or equivalently minimize the regret. This is a loss compared to the best in hindsight solution. Okay, so let's move on to linear partial monitoring. As in the bandit setting, the learner has access to a set of actions and associated features. In addition, each action has an associated feedback map denoted by AX, which is also given. Again, the learner interacts with the environment on n rounds, and the learner chooses one of the actions at the beginning of each round. The key difference is that now the feedback is decoupled from the reward. The observation is given by the feedback map AX transpose theta, and it can also be multivalued. The reward is still the inner product of XT and theta, but the reward is not observed. The only way to learn about a reward is through the indirect feedback on theta from the feedback maps AX. Again, we are minimizing regret. This framework is quite general and captures many bandit models that have been studied in the literature, as I'm going to show now. Of course, linear bandits are just a special case, where the feedback is the same as the reward. We can also model heterostochastic bandits, where the signal-to-noise ratio depends on the actions. Other types of feedbacks are also possible, for example, dueling bandits, where the learner chooses two actions and observes the reward difference. Linear partial monitoring also captures the combinatorial bandit setting, both with bandit and semi-bandit feedback. This was the original motivation by Lin et al., who introduced the linear partial monitoring setting. We can also have semi and full information feedback, including, for example, network or graph bandits. There can also be tricky cases where the optimal action provides no information and the learner necessarily pays a cost to obtain information about X star. We have detailed many of these examples in the paper, but it should be clear from here that the partial monitoring setting captures a large class of bandit games that have been already studied in the literature and which have many applications. We will also see that the exploration-exploitation trade-off is more intricate than in the standard bandit setting. We propose an algorithm that is based on the information-directed sampling principle. This method has been introduced by Russo and Van Roy for the Bayesian setting, but here we use the frequentist version. To define information-directed sampling, assume we are given a regret estimate, which upper bounds the true gaps with high probability. This means a sum over the gap estimates is going to upper bound the true regret. Further assume that we are given a function that measures information gain. I'm going to get back to here with precise definitions in a moment. Before that, some notation. We allow the argument of the regret estimate and the information gain to be a distribution to denote the expectation. So delta t of mu is the expected estimated regret, and it of mu is the expected information gain under an action sampling distribution mu. At time t, IDS samples the action from a distribution mu t, which minimizes the so-called information ratio, which is the expected estimated regret squared divided by the expected information gain. There's a result which says that the IDS distribution can always be supported on two actions. For finite action sets, that means a naive implementation scales quadratically with the number of actions, but this can be improved to linear in some cases. Okay, so let's get back to the regret estimate and the information gain. For the regret estimate, we use a simple least squares estimator theta hat and standard confidence bounds to ensure that the estimate upper bounds the true gaps. Beta T is a scaling parameter that depends on the confidence level and is typically of order D log T. For the information gain function, several choices are possible. Here we use the increase of the log determinant potential for an observation AX. This corresponds to mutual information between the observation and the parameter in the Bayesian setting. We discuss some other choices in the paper as well. Okay, let's have a look at the standard argument bound the regret of IDS. First, we upper bound the regret using the regret estimates. Then we introduce the information gain to the sequence and use the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. For our choice of the information gain function, the sum over the information gain is bounded by a constant gamma n that is going to be of order d log n. IDS optimizes the information ratio that remains in a bound. From here on, the idea is to find suitable bounds for gamma t, and this is going to lead to different regret rates. But before getting to the bounds, let's have a look at what we know already. For finite partial monitoring without the linear structure, there's a classification result that says the regret can only be constant square root n to the 2/3 or linear. And these rates depend on precise observability conditions. Unfortunately, these results do not directly extend to the linear setting. We show that there are games in finite partial monitoring where the learner has constant regret. But the same game in the linear setting could be hard, having for example square root and n to the 2/3 or even linear regret. On the other hand, getting back to the examples, we know that many bandit models have square root regret, and other models like dueling bandits can have n to the 2/3. So what we're going to see next are precise conditions for the achievable regret in the linear case. Our first result is for globally observable games. If you think about it for a moment, a minimal assumption that we need is that we can estimate or reward differences from the feedback that we get. The precise condition that we need is that any difference vector of two actions is contained in the subspace spanned by the observation operators. With this assumption, we get our first regret bound. The bound depends on the horizon n, the width of the confidence set beta n, and the total information gain gamma n. We further introduce an alignment constant, which captures how well the feedback maps are aligned with the reward differences under the worst case parameter. Essentially, that's a signal-to-noise ratio. As you can see, in this case, the regret scales like n to the 2/3. So what is happening in cases where we know that square root n regret is possible? To get the faster rate, we have to make a stronger assumption about the feedback maps. First, we define the set of plausible maximizers P. Assume the true parameter is contained in some confidence set C. Then P of C is the set of all actions which are optimal for some parameter in C. The condition for locally observable games says that any reward difference between plausible optimal actions can be estimated by playing within the same set. This means that the learner needs to choose only plausible maximal actions according to the current confidence level, which significantly reduces the regret. As in the globally observable case, we also need a quantitative version of this idea. This is captured with the constant alpha zero that is detailed in the paper. With this assumption, we get the bound that is shown here. As we were hoping for, we now have a square root n rate. If we specialize this result to linear bandits, we recover the standard rate, which is optimal up to a square root log n factor. Here's an overview of the results from the paper. First, there's a trivial case where there's only one action in the action set. Obviously, in this case, any learner has zero regret. Second, with the local observability assumption, IDS achieves an n to the 1/2 rate, and we show that this cannot be improved except for trivial games. Third, on globally observable games, IDS has at most n to the 2/3 regret. We show that for finite action sets, without the local observability condition, this is essentially not improvable. Lastly, there's a case where the learner cannot estimate or reward differences, and then the regret is just linear. With these results, we classify all finite linear partial monitoring games, showing that, as in finite partial monitoring, the optimal regret rate is either 0, 1/2, 2/3, or linear. All bounds hold for continuous action sets. Only the lower bound for globally observable games explicitly uses that the action set is finite. We also showed that this is not an artifact of the analysis. In continuous games where the action set is sufficiently curved, the regret of IDS can be as small as square root n without the local observability assumption. For continuous games, this means that the regret rate can be anywhere between 1/2 and 2/3, and the exact characterization of the achievable regret rate is still an open problem. In the paper, we also discuss several extensions to the framework. The first extension is a contextual version of partial monitoring, similar to contextual bandits. Here the action set and the feedback maps are allowed to depend on the context that the learner observes at the beginning of each round. We showed that there is a natural extension of IDS to this setting. When the context follows some distribution, we can include this distribution in the information ratio. This way, IDS exploits the randomness of the context as part of the exploration distribution. The second extension is a kernelized version of partial monitoring, similar to kernelized bandits. Here, the reward function is contained in a reproducing kernel Hilbert space. This allows for many interesting applications, for example, where the learner obtains gradient feedback. And our framework also gives regret bound for many more settings, for example, the kernelized dueling bandit setting. Finally, we implemented a small toy example as a demonstration of the method. In this example, imagine a laser beam is pointed onto a wall. The goal of the learner is to shift a target plate into the position which maximizes light intensity. We have different types of feedback corresponding to different partial monitoring games. This setup is motivated from a real-world problem in electron accelerators. For more details, I refer you to the paper. To summarize, we studied the linear partial monitoring setting, which is a generalization of linear bandits. That includes many standard models like dueling bandits. We propose a new algorithm based on IDS, and we show that it achieves the optimal regret rate depending on different observability conditions. All bounds are achieved by exactly the same algorithm with no further tuning. We also work out several extensions, including kernelized partial monitoring and contextual partial monitoring. So thank you for watching and see you at the virtual conference.